Okay, today we're going to talk about cleaning the IPA. That's the alcohol that's used in the resin printing to clean up the prints. In case you don't know, there's several steps where you need to clean them. When the part is done on the printer, and you'd be hanging up here and all the excess is dripping off. Well, the resin is so thick, all the excess doesn't drip off. So you do an initial cleaning. I do it in this small bucket and with this chip brush, and wash off all of the large amount on the outside, get the bulk of it off, most of the mess. Then you go from that into, if you have a cleaning station like I do, you put it in your cleaner IPA. This is the one you want to try to keep clean, and clean off the rest. Then of course dry it, UV cure it, and you're good to go. But when this one starts getting too milky and too dirty, then you can't get the part clean enough and you can't move on. So I tried all of the methods I could find on YouTube for doing this, the sunlight, the standing the bucket outside, straining through multiple layers of paper towels, straining through coffee filters, straining through paint filters. They're all garbage. They're all generate a huge amount of waste. They all take forever. I mean, it could literally take a week in some cases to do just that one container's worth. All that garbage that's in that blue bucket is just from attempts yesterday. So finally, I decided I'd go ahead and try the method that seems to be best, but it's the most expensive if you buy it, and that's just to buy an alcohol distilling unit. Basically on Amazon you can buy them. They started life off as water distilling units, and they've claimed to have changed some secret part to make them for alcohol. I don't know. But just grabbing what I had in the shop and using my common sense and scientific know-how, I grabbed a hot plate down here that I used to use when I do metal plating, because the chemicals would have to be at a certain temperature. And you can see right now there's no light on it. It's only running at about 4, so it's not running hot. Then up above it, the only thing I had that had a lid that would seal, and there's no pressure involved, you just want to catch all the vapors, was this old pressure pot, you know, used for canning food. Well, about 25 years ago, I modified that into a pressure pot for when I did silicone mold making. You need to get all the air bubbles out, and it even had a pressure gauge on it and everything. But none of that's being used now. I went ahead and cut the air fittings off the end of this old rubber hose and jammed in some copper pipe that I had laying around. I wish I'd had a whole lot more, because you want the copper pipe to stay cold, so that as the vapors come up, they'll condense in the pipe and drip into your catching bucket as a liquid. So when it comes to adjusting the temperature, if you decide to fool with this sort of thing, you don't want the liquid in there boiling and going crazy. You want it to only generate enough fumes that your condenser can handle. Because if it's coming out the end of the condenser pipe as a mist, well, you're not going to be able to recover it, for one, and for two, that's kind of an explosive thing. I mean, alcohol burns well, and when it's a vapor, it burns even more. So you don't want to run it any faster than your condenser can condense it back into a liquid. So that's why I'm running this kind of slow. But having said slow, I got this LED light back behind there, so you can actually see the ripples in there. That's the drops coming down. It's come up that much, what, about a quarter of that container, I'd say in a half an hour. So it's actually going quite quickly. Now, as far as the yellow color, I'm not 100% sure why that's there, other than this old rubber hose that I put on there. I don't know what passed through that hose in the past, but I got a feeling it's picking up whatever that was and depositing it back down here, because theoretically when it's turned into a mist in this bucket, it should be coming out crystal clear. But I'll check that out when we're all done with this. When it's all done cooking, like I say, it's just warm. I can put my hand on that. It's not like I'm boiling it or anything. You should be able to take all of the sludge out of there, put it like into a baggie, then set the baggie out in the sun and pretty much solidify the sludge that's left to make it easier to dispose of in a reasonable way. So, keeping an eye on it, not doing anything crazy. There's no sparks or fires or anything going on in here. As you can see, I'm running the box fan to keep that small amount of copper pipe cold, If I had more copper pipe, I probably wouldn't need the fan, or at least not that big of a fan. I could maybe use a small computer fan or something to keep the copper pipe cold, you know, and blow the air up through the center of it all. But it was just a test, and so far it looks like this is working so much better than all of the ugly filter ways that you can find online, and all the expense and all of the waste. So I'm quite pleased with this so far, but if it doesn't work out, I'll certainly do a video and I'll let you know. If you decide to fool with it, you're doing so at your own risk. You need to know what you're doing, because you are playing with things that are flammable. So you don't want to do anything crazy. You don't want to have any sparks or fire. You don't want to be running anything so hot that steam is actually coming out the end of your pipe, because that means it's not condensed and you've now made something that's quite easily to explode. So if you decide to play with it, do so safely. I just thought I'd share with you what I threw together with the junk, and I got lots of junk laying around here, just to see if it would work. And if it does work, I may consider buying a professional unit. On the other hand, I'm the kind of guy that pretty much doesn't like to buy professional units when I can throw something together myself. So who knows, right?